Hey Central, I hope you're doing well today. We wanted to give you an update on where we are with the church. This has sure been a challenging time for our country and our world, and particularly for the church. When I attended seminary, took a class that said how to lead a church through a pandemic. So we've all been learning on the fly, so thanks for your patience. We've been working for several weeks on a plan, a phase-in reopening plan that we want to be cautious and conservative, yet at the same time, we also recognize our need to worship together. Our plan was approved by our district superintendent, and we're excited to announce the four-phase plan of what's going on for the next few weeks. The full details are on our website that you can access, but Audrey and I are just going to take a minute to talk about the first two phases of the plan.
Phase one will begin on June 21st, so next week we start. We'll have three places that you can worship on Sunday. The first, obviously, is in the sanctuary, but we'll be limited to 100 people because of social distancing. We'll have two other venues where you may be part of the service. One will be in the pavilion. We'll be limited to 50 people there, and it will be hosted by Evan Nestor, and it will be live streamed. The third venue will be in our gathering area, and it will be live streamed also, and it will be hosted by Sharon Yarbrough. Please come early so that you may be guaranteed a seat.
For phases one and two, we're not going to be able to have children's ministry or nursery ministry, so families will need to be together for those. Phase two will begin on July 4th weekend, on July 5th, actually. We'll be going to our normal schedule of 8:45 modern worship and 11 o'clock traditional worship. We will not have Sunday school because this will allow time for things to be cleaned out and the worship space is prepped for that. Please come early so we can have the same seating arrangements, 100 in the worship center, 50 in the pavilion, and 15 that will be in the gathering area. During this time, we'll also have limited small groups that can meet during the week in the worship center. This will eliminate some of the cleaning issues that we will have. And also, youth ministry may meet socially distanced outside during this time.
We'll be adhering to the strict guidelines set out for us by Governor Lee and Bishop Taylor. And these guidelines are, anyone entering the church will be required to wear a mask, and this is for children 2 and up and all adults. If you do not have one, we'll supply one for you, even for children. To help families, we'll have three different wiggle rooms, so if children are having a hard time sitting in the sanctuary, feel free to use one of those rooms. Please remember to keep a 6-foot distance. Only family members may sit together during the services. Children will sit with their families, and there'll be no handshaking, I'm afraid, or hugging. Please enter through the main doors by the gathering area and exit out the side door of the worship center by the parking lot. There'll be no physical children's or youth ministry at this time. Children and youth must sit together with their families as well. For those with vulnerable health conditions, cannot wear a mask or feel uncomfortable attending, or who are ill, you may watch the live stream service from home.
Audrey and I want to especially thank Rick Harvey and his team, who, with the emergency response team and the cleaning team, is doing such great work of keeping our church clean and safe currently and even when you arrive. We've talked to a lot of you who have various opinions about what's going on in our world and what our response to it is, from masks to all different kinds of things. We just encourage you as you come back just to remember to put the church first. Above our own personal opinions, you know, the golden rule to do unto others as you would have them do unto you. So we try to think of our other brothers and sisters in Christ above our own desires. So thank you for cooperating and being patient with us during this time. We encourage you, if you don't feel comfortable, you want to just take some time, we get it. So take the time you need, watch on our YouTube channel or on Facebook or on our website, so you can stay connected. We want to continue to be a ministry to you. But I do want to say, for those of you who want to come, would you please give us a heads up? Would you please email us or call us at our church number so that we can be prepared and have an idea of how many are going to be there on that first Sunday? We just want to be ready. Once again, we are really excited about coming back together again. So welcome back, Central. Welcome back.
Welcome back, welcome back. Welcome back.